Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about the atomic models. So now we have started the atomic physics series, as we done the nuclear series. So some parts on the atomic physics, and after that we come to the nuclear part. So let's start the video. Atom models. So I have discussed from Democritus to Bohr. Introduction. So सबसे पहले Democritus ने बताया था 460 to 370 BC. He asked if matter could be divided into smaller and smaller piece forever. So this is the summary. उन्होंने ये कहा कि क्या मैटर को हम डिवाइड कर सकते हैं स्मॉल से स्मॉल साइज में. एंड देन बाय जॉन डाल्टन इन 1766 to 1844, ही प्रपोज द एटॉमिक थ्योरी ऑफ मैटर बेस्ड ऑन इट्स एक्सपेरिमेंटल ऑब्जर्वेशंस. जॉन डाल्टन ने अपनी एटॉमिक थ्योरी दी है एक्सपेरिमेंटल ऑब्जर्वेशन के बेसिस पे. लेटर ऑन आई डिस्कस ब्रीफली. सो देन द थॉमसन इन 1856 to 1914, ही प्रपोज द प्लम पडिंग मॉडल ऑफ द एटम. एंड आफ्टर दैट द अनफेस थनफोर्ड 1871 to 1937, ही डिस्क्राइब द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम. And Niels Bohr, he explains how atomic spectra worked. So let's start the timelines of atomic models. Democritus proposed the first atomic theory in 460 to 370 BC, and then John Dalton, and after that J.J. Thomson's, and then Rutherford and Bohr theory. So this is the timeline of atomic structure. So first theory is Democritus atomic theory. The Greek philosopher Democritus began the search for a description of matter more than 24 years ago. So सबसे पहले atomic theory Democritus ने दिया था. उन्होंने ये कहा कि could matter be divided into smaller and smaller pieces forever, or was there is a limit to the number of times or pieces of matter could be divided. तो क्या हम किसी मैटर को स्मॉल से स्मॉल पीस में डिवाइड कर सकते हैं हमेशा, या कोई एक लिमिट है कि नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स हम कर सकते हैं डिवाइड. तो उनकी थ्योरी के अनुसार मैटर कुड नॉट बी डिवाइडेड इंटू स्मॉलर एंड स्मॉलर पीसेस फॉर एवर. इवेंचुअली वास्तव में स्मॉल पॉसिबल वुड बी ऑब्टेंड. तो एक स्मॉल पॉसिबल पीस जो ऑब्टेंड हो सकता है किसी भी मैटर का, उसको उन्होंने कहा कि यह इंडिविजिबल होगा, और उसे नाम दिया. दिस स्मॉल पीसेज ऑफ मैटर इज नोन एज एटमॉस, एंड दिस हैज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ नॉट टू बी कट. एटमॉस मीन्स नॉट टू बी कट. मतलब एटम्स ऐसे होंगे जिन्हें हम कट नहीं कर सकते, या उसे और छोटा पीस में कट नहीं कर सकते. सो टू डेमोक्रेटस एटम्स वर स्मॉल. तो उनके अनुसार एटम्स बहुत स्मॉल हैं, हार्ड पार्टिकल्स हैं दैट वेयर जो कट नहीं होंगे. वेयर ऑल मेड ऑफ सेम मटेरियल बट वेयर डिफरेंट शेप एंड साइज. एटम्स वर इनफाइनाइट इन नेचर, ऑलवेज मूविंग एंड कैपेबल ऑफ ज्वाइनिंग टुगेदर. तो जो एटम्स हैं वो इनफाइनाइट हैं नंबर में, और हमेशा मूव कर रहे हैं और एक साथ ज्वाइन करने के लिए कैपेबल हैं. नाउ डेमोंस्ट्रेटस एटॉमिक थ्योरी. उन्होंने ये शो कर रहा है कि एटम्स कितना भी बड़ा होगा उसको हम कट नहीं कर सकते. वो अदर अदर मैटर के लिए एटम्स की साइज़ डिफरेंट हो सकती है, लेकिन वो अनकटेबल होगा. नाउ डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थ्योरी. He proposed that atomic theory of matter based on his experimental observations, and the main postulates of the Dalton atomic theory are as follows. According to Dalton, all the matter is made of the atoms. जो सभी matter हैं वो atoms से मिल के बने हैं. Atoms are indivisible and equal or greater, spherical, indestructible, indestructible means उसको हम destruct नहीं कर सकते. The second is all atoms of a given element are identical in mass and properties. Compounds are formed by a combination of two or more different of atoms. So जो compound होंगे वो formed होंगे combination दो या उससे ज़्यादा atom type के atoms से. A chemical reaction is a rearrangement of atoms. And the next one is atoms can be neither created nor destroyed. Atoms को हम ना तो create कर सकते हैं ना ही destroy कर सकते हैं. He also calculate the atomic weight of the various elements. Clear? So these are the statement of Dalton's about the atomic theory. Now, Thomson's atomic theory. This experiment was done by Thomson and showed that the existence of electron radioactivity proved the fact that the atom consists of positively and negatively charged particle. So as the atoms is electrically neutral, the positive charge must be equal to negative charge. So the question arises as how the electrons are arranged in the atom. So Thomson suggest that the atom was spherical in shape and the whole mass of the atom was eventually distributed, and the positive charge was distributed all over the mass, and the electron with negative charge were embedded within the atom, and the whole positive charge of atom was equal to the total charge of the electrons, and the atom was like a plum pudding. So this model is known as the plum pudding model. It is in the year of 1897 he totally changed the view of an atom by discovering electron. इन्होंने एटॉमिक थ्योरी के बारे में सारा व्यू को चेंज कर दिया इलेक्ट्रॉन को डिस्कवर करके. थॉमसन एटॉमिक थ्योरी सजेस्ट दैट द एटम इज़ नॉट इंडिविजिबल. अकॉर्डिंग टू थॉमसन जो एटम्स हैं वो इंडिविजिबल नहीं है. जो अब तक इंडिविजिबल था डेमोक्रेटस और जैसे वो डाल्टन के हिसाब से, तो थॉमसन ने ये बताया कि एटम इज़ नॉट इंडिविजिबल एज इट वॉज मेडअप ऑफ स्मॉल पीसेस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड प्रोटॉन्स. सो इंडिविजिबल नहीं है, यह इलेक्ट्रॉन और प्रोटॉन से मिल के बना है और दोनों आपस में चार्ज न्यूट्रलाइज करते हैं, सो यह न्यूट्रल भी है. एन एटम कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए चार्ज ऑफ पॉजिटिव चार्ज विथ निगेटिवली चार्ज इलेक्ट्रॉन एम्बेडेड इन इट. जो एटम्स होते हैं वो कंसिस्ट करते हैं एक स्फीयर पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड विथ निगेटिवली चार्ज इलेक्ट्रॉन in between. The positive and the negative charges in an atom are equal in magnitude, due to which the atom is electrically neutral and it has no overall negative or positive charge. So atom has a neutral. So this is the plum pudding type model. So here these are the plums, these dots, and these are known as the plums, and this is the pudding. So जैसे केक में केक वाले हिस्से को हम पडिंग बोल सकते हैं, और जो उसमें काजू पिस्ता या बादाम जैसा होता है उसे हम प्लम बोलते हैं. तो दिस द टाइप्स ऑफ atomic theory. Also, the characteristics of Thomson model was the emission of electron, like photoelectric effect. Also, it provide the elastic hot model required for kinetic theory of gases. Also, this theory explain the existence of positively charged and negatively charged ions, and a gain in electron by neutral atom produces a negative ions, and the loss of an electron by the neutron atom by the neutral atom produces a positive ion. And some drawback also, the scattering alpha particle by the heavy atom studied by Rutherford led to the idea that the positive charge could not be distributed evenly in the whole mass of the atom. तो रदरफोर्ड का एक्सपेरिमेंट था, उसमें ये क्लियर हो गया कि जो मास है वो सभी पूरे इंटायरली एटम में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट नहीं होता, बल्कि कुछ सेंट्रलाइज्ड होता है, जो अल्फा पार्टिकल एक्सपेरिमेंट में पता चला. तो ये ड्रॉबैक रहा थॉमसन का. दिस इज़ द रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक थ्योरी. ऑन फर्स्ट रदरफोर्ड प्रेजेंटेड ए पेपर एक्यूरेटली डिस्क्राइबिंग द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम बेस्ड ऑन एन एक्सपेरिमेंट he had performed with totally unexpected result. He realized that the atom must have almost all of its mass centralized, concentrated at its center, in a nucleus with the vast majority of atoms consisting chiefly of empty space. So 2 years later, in 1909, he had conducted an experiment with two other scientists, Giger and Mastod, in which they study the deflection angles of alpha particles, and the experiment was the gold foil experiment. This experiment was done by many other metals to show how the effect comes by the different mass numbers. So 8 different metals are used, but the commonly this experiment is famous for gold foil. So different metals have the same thickness but a different mass number. But the experiment, because of the gold is most prestigious, so this experiment is known as a gold foil alpha scattering experiment. So they sought through a macroscopically thin layer of gold. Alpha particles are just helium atoms stripped of their 2 electrons. He saw that while the nucleus contains virtually all the mass of the atoms, it only takes up 1 billion of the volume of the atoms, an inconveniently teeny amount. Much smaller particles, electrons, orbit the nucleus at a great distance, relatively speaking. जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है वो अलग अलग एनर्जी से न्यूक्लियस के अराउंड चक्कर लगाता है. तो दिस इज़ द एक्चुअल रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक स्कैटरिंग मॉडल. सो दिस इज़ द गोल्ड फॉयल एंड दिस इज़ द सोर्स फ्रॉम वेयर अल्फा पार्टिकल्स आर इमिटिंग एंड दिस इज़ द गोल्ड फॉयल वेयर द टारगेट इज़ द गोल्ड फॉयल एटम्स. सो आफ्टर experiment it was found that the most particle went right through, but the some particles are deflected, and these are the screen we can detect anywhere in this screen. So there is a number of particles in different angles are coming out. So this experiment was very famous, and from here the nucleus concept was rise, and the nuclear physics, this is the beginning of nuclear physics. So from this experiment Rutherford came to the conclusion that the positively charged alpha particle must be encountering extremely dense concentration of the positive charge at the center of atom. If a number of bullets are fired through a sandbag containing a stone, some of the bullet striking the stone will be scattered. Thus, Rutherford considered the atom to be consisting of a nucleus containing a positive charge at its center, and the electrons were considered to be distributed around the nucleus in the empty space of the atom. Thus, the discovery of nucleus of the atom is due to the Rutherford, and the nucleus is of great importance to explain the modern experimental and theoretical facts. And this is the beginning of nuclear physics due to nucleus. Also, some drawback of Rutherford: the planetary electron is constantly attracted towards the nucleus, and an electron must emit the electromagnetic radiation. So if electron emit electromagnetic radiation as it rotates, it will finally be drawn nearer the nucleus, and as the electron spiral down to the nucleus, it must emit electromagnetic waves of all frequencies. So this fact contradicts the experimental result, because according to Rutherford model, electron can rotate in any orbit of any radius and thus must emit electromagnetic radiation of all frequencies. This is also contrary to the experimental result, because experimentally it was found that for a hydrogen atom emitted line spectra of fixed frequencies only, not the various frequency, line spectra of fixed frequencies only and not of all frequencies. So this led Bohr to suggest a new model of the atom, and that is the Bohr atomic theory. So Rutherford ke anusar agar electron revolve kar raha hai kisi bhi kaksha mein, agar wo revolve kar sakta hai, uska motion agar is spiral ho raha hai, to wo लगातार अपनी एनर्जी को लॉस करेगा और लास्ट में न्यूक्लियस में गिर जाएगा, जबकि ऐसा होता नहीं. तो ये ड्रॉबैक था रदरफोर्ड का, जिसकी वजह से बोर ने एटॉमिक थ्योरी दिया आगे. सो नील बोर रिफाइंड द रदरफोर्ड्स मॉडल इन 1913 बाय प्रपोजिंग दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स orbit the nucleus without losing energy, could move only in fixed orbit of specific energy. तो उन्होंने कहा कि जो orbit है, जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है वो without lose किए हुए energy orbit करता है nucleus को, and could move only in fixed orbit of specific energies. An electron with low energy would orbit closer to the nucleus, while electrons with high energy orbit further from the nucleus. So this electron having low energy, so move nearer to the closer to the nucleus, and this electron having high energy, so move further from the nucleus. This is the nucleus. And for this experiment he was awarded Nobel Prize for Physics in 1922. He suggests that the electrons are negatively charged particle and move round the nucleus in various orbit, and the orbit of an electron is fixed. He gave the name energy level to these orbits. The electron can emit any energy when it moves. When it moves in its fixed own orbit, that is known as stationary energy level. So these are the models up to the Bohr. So I think this video is very helpful. Thanks for watching video. Thank you.